join a PFAC, a Patient Family Advisory Council, and get to know activists and try to understand their experience and what's important to them. I also would say learn more about PCORI, the Patient-Centered Outcomes Research Institute.
There are two steps. The first step is to look at the literature that is there to find out what people are currently publishing, and then to make connections with two different types of people. The first type is the people who are currently writing the articles that are being published, but the second type is the people who are publishing them so that they can find out what it is that they need to do if they want to get into that arena themselves.
One of the places I'd start is by volunteering to be a peer reviewer. This is a fantastic way to see how the sausage is made, as it were, and actually realize that a lot of the publications you see have gone through two or three or four rounds of iteration with expert input. And that actually, you know, your role there will give you a different perspective on how research is done. I think one of the things that I found most useful was to realize, yes, it was challenging doing my research. Everyone else had challenges as well. And there is no perfect research study out there. There's only, you know, what we're able to do with the constraints in which we operate. So I think that is very important.
An area that I do teach in and advise students is around working with end-of-life issues, around decision-making as one lives a life with a chronic illness that is progressive and life-limiting. This really is an area that people are very uncomfortable talking about and hasn't really been explored that much.
So if you're a young PhD student and you're looking to do some research in this area, you don't know where to start, I think, you know, the first thing I would do probably is start perusing the literature and, look for keywords, look for keywords like participatory healthcare, patient engagement, those sorts of things. Do some reading. I would also talk to people who have done research in that space, perhaps some of the authors of these articles, but also leaders, you know, thought leaders in this area, you know, people like members of the Society for Participatory Medicine, for example. I think by doing that, you'll be able to craft a research agenda that I think would be very exciting.
One other piece of advice I would offer is that editors are very keen to receive pre-submission inquiries. They don't want to waste their time or their peer reviewers' time bringing a manuscript through the system that's just not appropriate for their audience. So I think before just saying, I'm going to list out the impact factors of all the journals and, you know, just throw it to the top and work your way down, I think it would be helpful to just go out and say, well, where has similar work to mine been published? Where can I reach out to the editors and actually ask them, you know, if the abstract was this and the title was this, here's the case that I would make. This is an interesting piece of work. And just get that discussion going, because yes, we do have the formal steps and the processes of the submission, and those are very important. But oftentimes, just that conversation can save a lot of work, save a lot of energy. And I found that going to the right journal first time significantly reduces the period in which your paper is in limbo, rather than just maybe trying to go to a prestige journal with a 95% rejection rate and then, you know, waiting for those depressing rejection emails.
As an academic, I'd strongly recommend that you partner with a senior investigator and a senior writer. Make sure that you write in a clear and simple way.
I think it's really finding how you can use your skills and your interests to make the world a better place in whichever way interests you.
The biggest hindrance, the biggest barrier I find is simply doing it. So just show up and write something, get it out there, and then worry about how to fix it. You might be surprised. It might be accepted right away, or it might need some tweaks. But put something out there, make the change.